Hello, what's up, everyone? I'm Adam Banks, and I'm the host of Off the Cuff. You are listening to Radio Lex, the voice of the people, WLXU 93.9 FM, Lexington.
The views expressed on this program are not necessarily the views of Lexington Community Radio or its board of directors. The views expressed are solely those of the programmers.
You are listening to Off the Cuff. Now, here's your host, Adam Banks.
Welcome, everybody, to Off the Cuff. I am Adam Banks coming at you live from Lexington, Kentucky. Thank you for listening to the show, and thank you for tuning in to WLXU 93.9 FM. In addition to listening to us on the radio, you can check out our Facebook live stream at Off the Cuff with Adam Banks, or you can download the Radio Lex app on your smartphone device to listen to us anywhere in the entire world. Amber Turner and I are both broadcasting from the Deborah Hensley Studios here at Radio Lex on North Limestone. It is December the 1st, 2022. It is officially Christmas time. Christmas time, Amber, is here.
It's the holiday season.
It is the best time of the year. I always say the day after Thanksgiving, all the way up to December 25th at midnight.
Gosh.
It is Christmas time.
You keep that on the top frame.
It is Christmas time. I'm very, very excited. It is now appropriate to deck your halls, to get your Christmas tree up. Have you done that?
I have got my tree up, but I have not decorated my staircase. So there's no garland or tinsel up just yet.
Well, you better hurry up and get it up because December 25th.
I know. You got me on that time frame.
We'll be here before you know it. But it is the holiday season. It is Christmas time here at Off the Cuff with Adam Banks. Some of my favorite episodes are the episodes that we do around Christmas time just because of the cheerfulness, the glee, the jolly in the air. We will be reading letters to Santa this month, so get your letters to Santa in. Send it to Off the Cuff with Adam Banks on Instagram, Facebook. You can send it to me on my social media. You can send it to Amber on her social media. The point is just get your letter to Off the Cuff with Adam Banks by any means. We check all social media, so make sure that you get that in and we will read those letters. And I know Santa Claus personally listens to this show. So if you want a direct line to Santa, Off the Cuff with Adam Banks is the best place to listen. It is a huge show today. Also on the show, I will be revealing Off the Cuff's 10 most fascinating people of 2022, according to yours truly, Adam Banks, and we'll get that started in the second segment. But I'm very excited. Off the Cuff with Adam Banks has been doing the 10 most fascinating people since 2016. It is a holiday tradition.
Yes, it is.
You know how Barbara Walters always did her most fascinating people?
Yeah.
And Time always does theirs. They always did it around the holidays. The holidays is a time to have a special, and it just so happens that our special here at Off the Cuff with Adam Banks is the 10 most fascinating people.
And plus, it gave people all year to prove that they were fascinating.
Exactly. So if you're not on the list, don't get mad at me, folks.
Oh, that was a jab at me.
But Christmas time is here, and what better time to read some Christmas facts for your evening drive. It is December the 1st. The tallest Christmas tree ever displayed, Amber, was in Seattle, Washington. It measured 221 feet tall.
I would hate to have been the person to put the star on that.
Exactly. That's a lot of height.
That's a lot.
Buying all the gifts from the 12 days of Christmas would cost you a ton of money. The most expensive being a swans a swimming. That would cost you about $6,300.
Oh my gosh.
Yeah. Yeah, the guy who sang about all those things he wanted to buy his true love for Christmas.
Yeah.
Or apparently his true love bought him those things for Christmas.
Yeah.
Those were expensive gifts.
Now, where do I sign up for that true love?
Black Friday is not the busiest shopping day of the year, like most people think. The 2 days right before Christmas is the two busiest days. One third of the 20 highest grossing movies were released during the Christmas season, proving that going to the movies after opening gifts is a popular tradition. A lot of people like to go to the movies on Christmas. We've talked about that here before. It was something that you and I could never really enjoy as kids because we didn't have movie theaters where we were from. But a lot of movies, a lot of big movies are released around Christmas time.
They are.
What's going on this year?
Oh my goodness, I honestly don't think we have too much. You know, it's been running sparse.
And that's probably because of streaming. A lot of streaming services put bangers of movies on there.
They do.
And then there's no reason to go to the movies anymore.
Except popcorn.
It is a tradition in Japan to eat KFC for Christmas. Orders must be placed 2 months in advance.
Oh gosh, I ate KFC last night on the fly.
One in three men wait until Christmas Eve to do their shopping.
Uh-huh.
I used to do that. Way too much stress.
Yeah.
Christmas came from the words Christus Messe, meaning Mass of Christ.
Okay.
I hate to break it to everybody, but Christmas is a Christian holiday.
Yes, it is.
Do you understand people that celebrate Christmas that do not believe in Jesus Christ?
Well, I mean, I guess it does sing, like it signifies love and family and unity, so I'm going to let them have it.
I don't get it. But Christmas trees usually grow for close to 15 years before they can be sold.
Seriously?
Yes. Paul McCartney earns $400,000 a year from his single Wonderful Christmas Time.
I ain't ever even heard it.
We played it on Off the Cuff last year.
I was absent that
singing night. Singing a Wonderful Christmas Time.
Oh, okay. That is him.
And that song is widely regarded as the worst song ever recorded.
Maybe that's why I didn't remember it.
Think about that, Amber. One single earns him $400,000 a year. That's the same salary as the President of the United States.
And that was his worst one.
More than 400,000 illnesses are caused by spoilt Christmas leftovers.
Ooh.
Christmas used to be illegal. Oklahoma was the last U.S. state to declare Christmas a legal holiday in 1907.
What do you mean illegal?
You couldn't do it.
No Christmas trees?
Probably because of the separation of church and state, I would assume. Christmas is not Christ's birthday, as many believe. According to the Bible, Christ was actually not even born in the winter. Of course, I think everybody knows that. It's hard to pinpoint the date that Jesus Christ was born. What date was it? I don't know, but December 25th is the day we've set aside to celebrate it. So folks get all bent out of shape when you say, happy birthday, Jesus. And everybody's like, well, it ain't really his birthday. Guys, it's the day we've set aside. We don't know the exact date.
No.
We don't know the exact date, but it was cold.
Okay.
It was cold outside, so we do know that it was in the wintertime. The original location for the 1947 Miracle on 34th Street movie was the New York Macy's in Herald Square. However, the remake in 1994, which is the best one with Matilda, Macy's refused to participate. Therefore, they had to create a fictional store, and they called it the Kohl's store.
Oh.
Why didn't Macy's participate in that?
I don't know. That don't make no sense.
Free publicity.
Well,
Toys for Tots was founded in L.A. 5,000 toys were collected during the first drive in 1947. A handmade doll was the first donation. Bing Crosby's version of White Christmas is the highest-selling single of all time.
Yes.
To me, that's not even the best version of that song. I like the Drifters.
I'm dreaming of a white Christmas.
It only took 6 weeks for Charles Dickens to write A Christmas Carol.
Okay. I like that one.
It takes me months to write a paragraph for a book.
I thought you were going to say it took you months to read it.
Americans purchase 1.6 billion Christmas cards every year. Have you sent out your Christmas cards?
I'm not doing them this year.
No, why?
Nah, you know, I just not feeling it.
Franklin Pierce was the first president who put up an official White House Christmas tree. December 25th was likely chosen because it coincides with the pagan festival where there was partying, gambling, and gift giving.
Oh, gambling.
Yeah, all that sin for Christmas makes a lot of sense. Christmas lights were so expensive that they used to be rented rather than sold.
Ooh.
An electrically lit tree was a status symbol in the early 1900s. So if you were someone who lit a Christmas tree in your mm-hmm. own home or had your own personal Christmas lights,
yeah.
that was a status symbol.
Hey, I still think it is.
You were rich. Absolutely.
Yeah.
I hate the fact that people don't decorate their houses
Yeah, rich
anymore.
In spirit.
Even if you want to go out and buy one of those projectors that has
yes.
lights, I'm okay with that because it still makes your house lit up.
Just do a little something. Make you feel better. Make you smile.
But if I had my own decision of what to put on people's houses, it would be the big fat bulbs
yeah.
with the colors.
Oh, geez.
Bring back the colorful bulbs.
Shoot.
I don't know when we decided to go to icicles.
Well, I think they're easier to hang and... they don't blow as fast.
The city of Vancouver, Canada, claims to be the birthplace of the first ugly Christmas sweater party.
Well.
From performers to maintenance workers, approximately 220 people are hired for the Disneyland Christmas parade.
Ooh.
Yes. In 2012, there were more than 15,000 holiday decorating injuries during November and December, the most common being falls, 34% of all injuries.
Mm-hmm.
That's probably people going to hang their Christmas lights.
Putting up them icicle lights.
Exactly. Exactly. It says here that the first Christmas celebrated on American land was in 1539 in Tallahassee, Florida.
Wow.
There were no trees, presents, just a religious mass.
Okay.
Christmas this year is on a Sunday. I wonder how many churches are going to cancel their church service because it's a holiday.
I hope not.
And people will laugh when I say that, but I'm not joking. I guarantee you there will be churches that will close their doors because it's a holiday.
The irony
in that.
That's breaking my heart.
The word Merry and Merry Christmas was not always accepted, because being merry used to signify slight intoxication.
Oh.
The highest grossing movie about Christmas since 1980 is Jim Carrey's How the Grinch Stole Christmas. It came out 22 years ago.
Wow.
And it pulled in $260 million.
Shoo.
A great movie. Not as good as the cartoon.
Cartoon's amazing.
And the cartoon's from the 50s?
Yes.
50s.
And it's just a man narrating.
Mm-hmm. The Charles W. Howard Santa Claus School in Midland, Michigan hosts 130 Santas each year where they gather Whoa. And learn about the history of St. Nick, popular toys, and Santa etiquette. In
wow.
1980, the highest-selling Christmas toy was a Rubik's Cube for $1.99.
Oh.
It now retails for $10. The abbreviation X in Xmas is not an abbreviation. It actually stands for Chai, meaning Christ in Greek. And a lot of people, they like to say Merry Xmas. They like to write Merry Xmas. And a lot of people will say, see, that's not sacrilegious because X means Chai, meaning Christ in Greek. Here's what I have to say about that. When you say it, how do you feel after you say it? That's all I'm going to say. And if you don't feel anything, maybe you need to do some more self-evaluation.
You know I ain't an Xmas woman.
The first batch of eggnog originated from medieval Britain's drink Posset, a hot Mickey L-like drink. The most popular theory of why we leave cookies and milk out for Santa is because Dutch children would leave food and drink out for St. Nicholas on his feast day.
Well,
the reason we give presents during Christmas to symbolize the gifts given to Jesus by the three wise men.
Mm-hmm.
We talked about that last
mm-hmm.
year. And finally, folks, finally, the last Christmas fact is Krampus is a demonic character
Ooh.
That wanders the streets with chains and bells looking for misbehaving children. This is one of the scariest Central European Christmas traditions.
And a scary Christmas movie.
Very much so.
Not as scary as Jack Frost. But it's still pretty scary.
Yes, but that is some Christmas facts, ladies and gentlemen, to start out this Christmas holiday season. We are in the holiday season. Thanksgiving is over. We've been off for 2 weeks.
Oh, I know.
So much has happened. Amber, did you have a good Thanksgiving?
I did. Did you?
I was very good. Had two Thanksgivings. Spent it with both parents.
Yeah.
And had a really good time. And I'm very excited to get this next holiday here. But the best time of Christmas is right now, just enjoying the season.
Yes.
So we will be playing Christmas music from now until Christmas time. So ladies and gentlemen, sit back, relax, and enjoy the show today. And when we come back... It is time for Off the Cuff to reveal its 10 most fascinating people of 2022, according to Adam Banks. We will be right back.
Happy holidays.
Happy holidays.
Happy holidays.
Happy holidays.
While the merry bells keep ringing, happy holidays. Season and Santa Claus.
Welcome back, everybody, to Off the Cuff. Adam Banks here with you. Amber is also in studio with me. It is the holiday season. Christmas time is here. We were reading Christmas facts on the first segment. I left this one off on accident. A Facebook study in 2010 revealed that 2 weeks before Christmas is the most popular time for couples to break up. Do you think that's because they're not wanting to buy a gift?
I think every dude that broke up with me before Christmas, that's 100% what it was.
You're putting it on the dudes then?
Well, no, I can't take no blame on myself. No, I do. I think people really do break up because they don't want to buy the other person something for Christmas.
It makes a lot of sense. Ladies and gentlemen, it is the holiday season, and one of the things we love doing around the holidays is to do this. Off the Cuff's 10 most fascinating people of 2022, according to Adam Banks. And this is a list that I've been doing since 2016. This list, in order to make the list, you have to be fascinating. The word fascinating, if you look up the word fascinating in the dictionary, it means extremely interesting. Now, in order to be on this list, that's what you have to be. For the year of 2022, you had to be extremely interesting. You had to be very newsworthy. You had to be somebody that people talked about a lot in 2022. Not previous years, not past years. 2022 is the year. Now, if you're on the list, does that mean that I like you, that I respect you? It could, or it could not. Just because you're on the list doesn't mean that I'm a fan of you or I like you. It's so, like, if you hear a name on the list and it just so happens to be someone that's a horrible human being in society, know that I don't agree with this person and some of the things and views that they have, but it doesn't change the fact that they were still fascinating. They were still extremely interesting and extremely newsworthy. All right, so Amber, without any further ado, are you ready to hear Off the Cuff's 10 most fascinating people of 2022, according to Adam Banks?
Let's hear them.
All right, first, ladies and gentlemen, before we go over the list, I just want to talk about the previous list.
Yeah.
I've been doing this since 2016, and a lot of people are probably wondering, you know, who are some of people that list.
Okay.
You had number 10, Tyler Ulis. 9, Harambre, that was the gorilla from Cincinnati.
Yeah.
This one might surprise you. Number 8 was Mark Stoops.
Oh.
Number 7, Donnie Tindall. 6, Benny Snell. 5, Ronda Rousey. 4, Josh Cook, the Winchester coach. 4, Steven Johnson. 3, John Hank from the Pokemon Go creator. And then Donald Trump was your number one.
Yeah.
2017, I had on the list, I had Donald Trump at 10. Kim Jong-un, Dolly Parton, Rick Pitino, Tom Jurich, Eric C. Kahn.
Woo.
The This Is Us cast.
Yeah.
Ryan Seacrest, Colin Kaepernick, and LeVar Ball.
Okay.
Was the most fascinating person. In 2018, I had Joe McElroy. He was from the Pop Watch videos. I had Mark Stoops on the list again.
Ooh.
Yes.
Repeat.
Zion Williamson, Brett Kavanaugh, Chadwick Boseman, Matt Bevin, Kevin Hart, Ben Shapiro, Roseanne.
Hey.
And the most fascinating of 2018 was the yodeling boy.
Oh.
From Walmart.
Yeah, from Walmart.
In 2019, I had R. Kelly, Lynn Bowden, Matt Jones, Nora O'Donnell, Rocky Atkins, Nick Sandman, James Halzer, which was the Jeopardy winner, Maddie Roberts, which was the alien Air 51 dude, Lee Cruz
oh.
on the list, Breonna Taylor and the most fascinating, well, I'm sorry, not Breonna Taylor, Lee Cruz and Lori Loughlin was 2019.
Oh.
2020 was Will Smith.
Okay.
Julia Garner, Charles Booker, Kamala Harris, Andy Beshear, Eric Yuan. Eric Yuan was the creator of Zoom.
Oh.
Jack Harlow, Ellen DeGeneres, Breonna Taylor, and Dr. Fauci.
Okay.
Was the most fascinating of 2021. Last year's list, number 10 was Lil Nas.
No.
The Rock, Liam Cohen, who was the coach for UK, Will Levis, quarterback for UK, Happy Mo Bellini, the Hazard mayor, Joe Biden, Elon Musk, Britney Spears, Harry and Meghan Markle made the list. And then the most fascinating person of 2021 was Kyle Rittenhouse.
Oh, he was the shooter, wasn't he?
Yes. And that, ladies and gentlemen, brings us to this year's list. This is the 10 most fascinating people of 2022, according to Adam Banks. And we will start the list at number 10, ladies and gentlemen, with Chris Rock. Ooh. Now, we can't not put Chris Rock on the list. This was from the Slap Heard Around the World, the Academy Awards. This year happened when Will Smith absolutely rocked Chris Rock's world by slapping him in the face. And Chris Rock made the list because of how he handled the situation, how he handled it with grace and dignity. Let me take you back to that infamous moment.
Jada, I love you. G.I. Jane 2, can't wait to see it. All right? That was a nice one. Okay. I'm out here. Uh-oh. Richard. Oh, wow. Wow. Will Smith just... Wow, dude.
Yes.
It was a G.I. Jane jump.
Keep my wife's name out your... No!
I'm going to, okay?
He's going
so
to.
I can, oh, okay.
And he did.
Yeah. But gosh almighty.
And the fact that he finished presenting that award and was able to get the words out, he didn't press charges on Will. He handled it with grace. I'm not a Chris Rock fan.
Yeah.
Never have been. But in that moment, I think that he come out better on top.
Yeah, looked like a grown man.
Now, number 9 on the list has to be the guy who slapped him, right?
Oh,
Will
gosh.
Smith making the list... Again, he's a 2-time Off the Cuff with Adam Banks fascinating list participant. He comes in at number 9. Will Smith has had one heck of a year in 2022, maybe the best year of his life and the worst year of his life. As a matter of fact, the Oscars, he says, was the worst day of his life and the best night of his life.
Oof.
How does that happen?
I mean, I don't know.
Now, Will Smith has recently did his first full sit-down interview since the Chris Rock slap at the Oscars back in February 2022. He did it just last week with Trevor Noah on The Daily Show. This is what Will Smith had to say.
Yeah, that was a horrific night, as you can imagine. You know, there's many nuances and complexities to it, you know. But at the end of the day, I lost it, you know? And I guess what I would say, you just never know what somebody's going through, you know? Mm. You know, in the audience right now, you know, you're sitting next to strangers, you know? And somebody's mother died last week, you know? Somebody's child is sick. You know, somebody just lost their job. Somebody just found out their spouse cheated. You know, there's all these things and there's strangers and you just don't know.
How true is that?
What's going on with people, you know?
You don't know.
And
it doesn't excuse what he did.
I was going through something that night, you know? And not that, you know, justifies my behavior at all.
No,
I would just say, you know, you're asking what did I learn? And it's that. We just got to be nice to each other, man. You know, it's like
I don't know. know where he says that, but after he slaps the crap out of somebody.
If he didn't say, you know, at least 100 times in that clip, then I'm not sitting here right now, you know?
Will Smith be able to come back from the slap?
I wish he would just man up, and I hate to say it like that. Just say, man, I'm sorry, I couldn't take a joke that night. I was mad at my woman, and I took it out on you. I think if he'd say that, I wouldn't have no beef with him.
Number 8 on the list is Jenna Ortega.
Yes.
I think possibly the best, most prominent up-and-coming actress
yes.
of 2022 is Jenna Ortega. I've been trying to wrap my head around the year that Jenna Ortega has been having because of the success of projects that she's mm-hmm. put out. Now, whoever don't know who Jenna Ortega is, if you don't know who she is from the TV series You. She was one of the main characters in the season 2 of the Netflix hit You. She also was in Scream 5. She was the girl that survived the opening scene,
mm-hmm.
the first ever girl to survive the opening scene of a Scream movie. And then recently, she dropped a brand new show on Netflix as Wednesday Addams.
Yes.
On a show called Wednesday. Have you got a chance to see that?
Oh, absolutely.
She plays Wednesday just as good as Christina Ricci did.
Oh, my goodness.
That come out in November of 2022. And she's also got a new movie coming out very early in 2023. She'll be starring in the new Scream 6
Ooh.
Movie. I do think that her star is very bright and
yes.
it's rising.
Yes, absolutely.
Number 7 on the list is another two-time list maker. It is Elon Musk. Ladies and gentlemen, another fascinating year for the billionaire. He has purchased Twitter. He purchased it for $44 billion, and he says that he bought it to improve the freedom of speech in this country. And boy, oh boy, has Elon Musk been making waves with Twitter. He's already reinstated Trump back to Twitter.
Oh.
So if you followed Trump before and you look at your followers, you'll notice that you have an extra follower because he's just being reinstated.
Is he using it? I wonder?
No, he says he does not plan on using it because the social media that he created is much more successful than Twitter.
Oh, I still haven't seen it.
Trump, you're going to have to get back on social media if you want to have a serious campaign.
Yes.
So you just have to get back on there. Elon Musk, though, he was fascinating last year. He's still just as fascinating this year. Number 6 on the list of Off the Cuff's 10 most fascinating people, according to Adam Banks, here in 2022 is Max Duffy. Max Duffy was the guy that I had on the show before. He was a former punter for the University of Kentucky. He currently is the host of the Pin It Deep podcast for the KSR podcast group. Max is a local guy, and he's definitely been a fascinating person in 2022. Talk about a guy who also has a rising star. He has made a name for himself in the state. He has become pretty much an official member of the KSR team. When you mention his name in the state, people know who he is.
Mm-hmm.
Now, I'll credit Off the Cuff with Adam Banks for a big part of that. No. Kidding, Max. But I also thought it was very appropriate for Max to be on my list because earlier in the year, Max released a list of his own,
mm-hmm.
and it was his top 10 media members,
yeah.
and I was number 9. Max, I was going to put you on my fascinating list of 2022 regardless of where you put me on your list, but number 6 is a pretty good spot. As a matter of fact, you are right above Elon Musk.
What better place to be?
Now, I was listening to the Pin It Deep podcast, the podcast that Max Duffy hosts, and I recently asked a question to Max and Miles on their show. I tweeted them a question about Mark Stoops, just being tongue-in-cheeky.
Yeah.
And this is the question that I asked. Take a listen.
Our good friend Adam Banks. For those of you that have not listened to the Adam Banks episode, he is possibly the biggest Mark Stoops hater in the world. I would love to get Stoops in the fired-up mood that he was on Saturday and sit him down next to Adam Banks and just give him a piece of his mind. But Adam likes to chime in every now and then when Spooks loses or we lose games, and he's probably the only man in Lexington who's happy. He gives us a little sarcastic question here, Miles. Do you think Stoops will get another raise slash extension if he keeps the score close against Alabama next year?
I didn't know we played Bama next year.
We do.
We do. And
I mean, the joke.
It is funny that I asked that, but it was just tongue-in-cheek.
Just a question.
Max definitely has made waves, though, and you have to hand it to him for doing what he's done just in 1 year. So he's definitely had one hell of a year. So, Max Duffy, you do make the list at number 6. But, ladies and gentlemen, that is numbers 10, 9, 8, 7, and 6. If you want to hear numbers 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, you are going to have to wait after these words. We'll be right back.
Deck the halls with boughs of holly, fa-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la. Tis the season to be jolly, fa-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la. Don we now our gay apparel, fa-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la.
Welcome back, everybody, to Off the Cuff. Adam Banks here with you. Amber is also in studio with me. I have been revealing the 10 most fascinating people of 2022, according to Adam Banks. We released numbers 10, 9, 8, 7, and 6 on the last segment. Now it's time to finish the list. Amber, coming in number 9, or number 5 on the list of Off the Cuff's 10 most fascinating people of 2022, according to Adam Banks, is the famous producer Ryan Murphy.
Oh.
Now, Ryan Murphy has proven to be one of the most prolific directors and producers working today.
Yes.
He's no stranger to receiving accolades and other attention for his work, but just the work he's put out in 2022 alone makes him fascinating. Ryan Murphy, the stuff he's done before 2022, he did American Horror Story.
Yes.
He did American Crime Story, where he did the feature on Bill Clinton and Monica Lewinsky,
mm-hmm.
and then the O.J. Simpson trial.
Mm-hmm.
And then here in 2022, he created the Jeffrey Dahmer monster documentary,
ooh.
Which was Netflix's most watched documentary or docuseries or miniseries of all time.
Mm-hmm.
He also had a movie called Mr. Harrigan's Phone.
Yes.
Which was a Stephen King movie.
Was good.
Which was a good movie. And also another hit show he dropped on Netflix this year was The Watcher.
Yes.
Now, The Watcher has been renewed for a second season.
Good.
And also, Jeffrey Dahmer was so successful, Netflix decided to make that an anthology series,
mm-hmm.
where going forward, Ryan Murphy has been greenlit to do other profiles of serial killers.
He has.
And what better person do you want doing it? Now, you might not know what this guy looks like, but I guarantee if you watch good TV, you see his name at the end of the show.
Oh, yes.
Are you a Ryan Murphy fan?
You already know. Been watching him since Glee.
He's won 6 Emmy Awards and 4 Producer Guild of America Awards, including a Lifetime Achievement Award for his contributions to television. And I just think he's getting started.
Yes.
And he's won a Lifetime Achievement Award.
Well, I mean, he's put out a lifetime worth of good work.
Number 4 on the list goes to Evan Peters. Evan Peters was the actor that played Jeffrey Dahmer in the Netflix series Dahmer. It's funny that Evan Peters makes the list this year because a lot of people already knew who he was before this. I didn't.
Mm-hmm.
But I never did watch American Horror Story. But I promise you, people know who he is now.
Absolutely.
Dahmer. If people that said they didn't watch it, they really did.
You're lying.
You're lying. I know you
Quit
did.
Lying.
I know you did. I know you've at least watched an episode. People that I know don't watch TV has at least watched a scene.
Yeah, just turned it on.
From that TV show. So Evan Peters is part of the reason for that success. Yes, Ryan Murphy, he produced it, but Evan Peters brought those words to life.
Exactly.
He brought the character, unfortunately, of Jeffrey Dahmer back to life. Yes. And he said here that he had to get into a dark place to play Dahmer. He said he watched as much footage that he could, including a lot of courtroom footage. He says that Dahmer had such a distinct voice and dialect. He said, quote, I worked with a dialect coach and then created this 45-minute audio composite that I listen to every day to stay in the accent, but also to really get into the mindset for the day and all the scenes we were shooting. I tried to attempt to understand what he was thinking and going through. I just tried to stay in it because it was too hard to go in and out of it. I studied how he moved. He didn't move his arms when he walked. He had a very straight back. He said, I wore weights on my hands to try to recreate his gait in order to walk like
him.
And he pulled it off. How many Halloween costumes did you see of Jeffrey Dahmer?
Oh, way too many.
And, of course, this is not somebody we want to make famous as far as the killer goes, but the work that Evan Peters did to recreate the monster of Jeffrey Dahmer was phenomenal.
Yes.
And I smell an Emmy in his future for this portrayal.
I hope so.
Number three on the list. Amber, we're getting close.
Okay.
Number three on the list, very newsworthy. Very big year. It was Pete Davidson.
Oh.
Ladies and gentlemen, for the last 8 years, Pete Davidson has been a cast member of SNL, but in 2022, he got fired.
Yeah. Oh, wait. He got fired?
Of course he did. A lot of people, and that always, when you get fired from SNL,
yeah,
it's a make or break for you.
Yeah.
You either have to go out and do something or your career's over.
Exactly.
Think about the people that's been fired from SNL. Adam Sandler.
Chevy Chase,
Mike Myers,
Dana Carvey,
Chris Farley, David Spade, Dana Carvey, comedy giants got fired, but all those people I named went on to do amazing,
great things.
Pete Davidson, it's now your time to go off and do those great things. It ain't going to happen. You're not a comedic genius.
No.
But in 2022, you sure have made headlines, and it's mainly because of who you dated.
Uh-huh.
He's got a very rich history of dating very hot girls. Ariana Grande.
Yeah.
Kim Kardashian.
Yeah.
That's the relationship that made him famous. And it was because that relationship that made him very famous because of his beef with Kim's ex, Kanye.
Yes.
Didn't they get into a text exchange?
Called him Skeet.
Yes. Yes. Kanye called Pete Skeet.
Uh-huh.
And
asked him how the mental facility was doing, I think.
And Kanye is
crazy thing.
Is the one to talk about
exactly
mental that's, facilities.
I think that's what made it so funny.
And then to retaliate, Pete sent Kanye a picture of him laying in Kim's bed.
He did.
And said, leave us alone.
Yeah, we're in bed.
We're in bed. Leave us alone. And that really made Kanye mad.
Didn't he even go get her kids, like, initials tattooed on him?
Yeah, he did.
Yeah, like.
And Britney Spears. She was on the list last year. Kanye, I think, scared Pete Davidson out of dating Kim Kardashian.
Oh, I don't. You really think?
I think that's why they broke up. I think he was scared. I think that it was too much on him, the stress of how crazy Kanye is.
Yeah.
Because they said that Pete Davidson apparently had a nervous breakdown on set.
Yeah.
Of a movie that he's working on. The stress is getting to him. Dating Kim Kardashian, I would say, is not easy.
It's only for grown men. And I say that very lovingly. It's for grown men. It's men that are just very secure with themselves.
But she don't want no grown man. She
no.
specifically wanted to date him who is like 10 years her age.
Yeah. Her junior.
Younger than her. Yes, her junior. He's like 5 years younger than me.
Yeah.
He's
wait, he's younger than us?
Yes.
Why does he look 40?
He's younger than us. I think he's 28.
Yeah.
Pete Davidson's young.
Buddy, they make them different these days.
They do.
Yeah.
He's just very tall, and tall people look older.
Yeah.
Because people associate.
I thought he was short.
People. No, he's not short. He's not. But it says here that Pete Davidson says this year was. Drew a lot of interactions online, etc. So, yes, number three on the list of fascinating people. Number two is going to go to Amber Heard.
Oh.
Amber Heard has become the most searched celebrity on Google of 2022. She has been in the news following her high-profile defamation trial against her ex-husband, Johnny Depp. She tried to sue Johnny Depp, uh-huh, saying that he was abusive. And what was amazing about that court trial was it was all on TV.
Yep.
And we found out that Amber Heard was the one doing the abuse.
Yep.
And it brought light to a situation that needed to have light brought to it.
Mm-hmm.
And that is men being abused in domestic violence.
It did.
It's always talking about women getting abused.
Yeah.
But this showed how monstrous Amber Heard was.
She went potty in his bed.
She did. She crapped in his bed.
She made a potty like pee in his bed.
Yes. And for that, in general, just makes her fascinating.
Yeah.
Pooping in his bed. Think about it. The most searched person of 2022 was Amber Heard. It says here that Amber has left behind American reality TV personality Kim Kardashian,
mm-hmm,
the Twitter owner Elon Musk. She also beat out the American footballer Tom Brady, actor Pete Davidson, and the late Queen Elizabeth II.
You mean she got more searches than the Queen?
Yes.
Goodness.
Yes. Queen Elizabeth was third on the list. Pete Davidson was second.
Okay.
And Amber Heard was first.
Yeah.
Of the most searched celebrity in 2022.
And I've only seen her in one movie.
What?
Magic Mike. That was it. Was she in anything else?
Aquaman. And I found that out because of the trial.
Oh, you know how I feel about movies like that. Rather slosh paint on the wall.
And a lot of people were looking up her on Google was because she was making such a fool of herself in front of everybody.
Very animated, very over the top. I think her dog got stung by a bee. I think that was the big thing at one point in time in the trial. Her dog got stung by a bee.
All right, ladies and gentlemen, it is time to reveal Off the Cuff's most fascinating person of 2022. But I think it's time for some music before we release
suspension.
That number one spot. I do think it's time for a little Christmas tune. So, ladies and gentlemen, you don't want to roll down them windows because it's cold. But get by the fire and turn that heat up and relax and listen to Off the Cuff Song of the Week with a little Christina Aguilera this Christmas. We'll be back after the song to reveal the most fascinating person of 2022.
Hang all the mistletoe. I'm on
it. All right, ladies and gentlemen, the time has come for me to reveal Off the Cuff's most fascinating person of 2022, according to Adam Banks. Ladies and gentlemen, the number one spot. Amber, can I get a drum roll, please? Ladies and gentlemen, Off the Cuff's most fascinating person of 2022, according to Adam Banks, is Brittany Griner.
Yes.
Of the WNBA takes this year's spot. Another female making the number one on the list. Lori Loughlin is the other female that made the number one spot. And now the other female to do it is Brittany Griner. She was the one that was arrested on February the 17th, 2022. She was arrested on smuggling charges in Russia. She was detained at an airport after they found her carrying a vape cartridge containing less than a gram of hash oil. Brittany had been prescribed medicinal cannabis in Arizona, which is illegal in Russia. On August 4th, the court found Griner guilty and sentenced her to 9 years in prison. They additionally fined her $16,301 American dollars as well. What I find fascinating about this story, Amber, is that number one, it's Brittany Griner. She is the Michael Jordan of women's basketball,
mm-hmm,
the most famous women's basketball player, I think, to ever play in the WNBA. And we've got the Michael Jordan female version in prison in Russia, and she's been there since February, and she got sentenced to 9 years in prison. It says on November 17th, Griner's lawyer said that she was transferred to IK2, a female penal colony in the town of Yavis in the region of Madorova. Previously, she was held in an undisclosed location. She went to prison for this long for hash oil.
Mm-hmm.
The things that people do in these states legally, I don't know how many, 20, 25 states have already completely legalized mm-hmm. marijuana. She's over there in Russia spending 9 years.
9 years.
For a cartridge?
For less than a gram.
Of hash oil. This is the only thing we've heard Brittany Griner say since she's been in prison, and this was right after her sentencing.
I want to also apologize to my parents, my siblings, my Phoenix Mercury organization back at home, the amazing women of the WNBA, and my amazing spouse.
During the
crazy to think that she is there that long for smuggling in a little weed. She probably didn't think that it would be that big of a deal if she got caught.
No, probably a fine.
Yes.
You know. But no, I mean, look what it has sparked. I mean, it's really got people. I mean, look, we've already almost completely cut ties with Russia, you know, because of their other antics. And then now this, oh man.
Yes. And it's crazy to think that she was sent to prison for that long. And it blows my mind. But that, ladies and gentlemen, is the list of the most fascinating people of 2022. Hope you enjoyed. But ladies and gentlemen, we still have one more segment to go, so stick with us. We'll be right back. Welcome back, everybody, to Off the Cuff. Adam Banks here with you. Amber is also in studio with me. Last segment of the hour. Man, this hour just flies by. Very quick show. Still so much to talk about. I didn't even get to touch on UK athletics, so that means I'm going to have to save me talking about the Mark Stoops contract extension at another time. I had plenty to say about it, but I'll get to it next week. I'll give you my thoughts. And I also want to give my thoughts on the Big Blue Nation next week, too. So it's an important show. This song kind of gives me PTSD when I hear it, Amber. It reminds me singing in the honor choir in high school, because I was in the honor choir. I don't know if you knew that.
I did.
But this song, we had to practice it, if not 50 times a day, it wasn't one. Gives me cochos when I hear it. What's your favorite Christmas song?
Oh my gosh. Probably Rocking Around the Christmas Tree.
With Brenda Lee?
Yes.
Is it because of the association it has with Home Alone?
No, just because I love the song.
Okay.
You know, I use it even just like normal day.
Okay. Or what?
Walking in a Winter Wonderland.
Oh, very nice.
Yeah, I like that one. My great-grandmother used to sing that one a lot.
We have not played that yet on the show.
Yeah.
So that will be one that we do play.
Looky there.
But ladies and gentlemen, believe it or not, we have come to another time of... What is that noise?
I have no clue.
Do you hear that?
Yeah.
It sounds like a buzzing.
I feel like there's a ticker going off.
Thank God it's at the end of the show. Ladies and gentlemen, that about wraps up another episode of Off the Cuff. If you like what you heard today, you'll like probably what we've talked about in the past. So subscribe to us on podcasts. We are on Apple Podcasts, Spotify, YouTube, or wherever you listen to your favorite podcasts. You can follow me on social media at The Adam Banks. You can follow Amber, the co-host, on social media at Ambu447. You can follow the show on Instagram and Facebook at Off the Cuff with Adam Banks. We release new episodes every Thursday live right here on WLXU 93.9 FM, which means we will be back next week from 4 to 5. Ladies and gentlemen, that is Amber Turner. I'm Adam Banks, and this is Off the Cuff We'll catch you down the road.